Hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com. Welcome right into this Photoshop tutorial where today we're going to take a look at some photo manipulation, namely creating a headless dude. So you can see here I got this photo and boop, just like that, his head's gone. We're going to take a look at how to create this effect in Photoshop, and it's going to be fast, it's going to be fun, and it's going to be easy. Now if you do enjoy this tutorial, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you never miss another Photoshop, graphic design, photography, or other related tutorial in the future. And without further ado, let's jump into Photoshop and check this thing out. Well, here we are in Photoshop. This effect will typically work best if you've got some kind of simple background behind the head that you're looking to make disappear. The more complex the background, the more difficult this effect will be to pull off, but it's always possible, and I don't necessarily have the most simple image here either. The first thing I'm going to do is grab the clone stamp tool and create a new layer over in the layers panel. I'm going to name this new layer Cover Up. And I'm going to use the clone stamp tool set to current and below up there in the top toolbar and carefully and tediously go over and over and over to replace, repair, correct, cover the current head with the background. And you just take some time and you can go in and make it look pretty realistic. Because here we're doing the cloning on its own layer, we can always add a mask and erase away some of the edges and clean this thing up a little bit, blend it, you know, a little bit more if need be. Now that his head is gone, we'll drag in a shot of a similarly colored shirt like I have here. I got this image from Adobe Stock. It's a pretty awesome place to find stock photography. They're good to me over there at Adobe Stock, so I appreciate them. Check them out, Adobe Stock. I'll position the shirt pretty close to where the collar is here, and I like to reduce the layer opacity of the shirt, that is, so I can see through this shirt layer and make sure everything is lining up, you know, kind of close to all right. It's not going to be perfect, and that's why we need to next go edit, free transform, and change the sizing of the shirt while holding the shift key. That's going to constrain to proper proportions. After that, right click within the transform box and choose distort, and here I'll further tweak and push and pull the shirt into place until it looks close to all right. And lastly, I'll right click within the transform handles again, and I'm going to choose the warp function, and this tool will really help us just squeeze and manipulate and push the collar and get it really inside the neck of the shirt in place where it needs to be. Next, hold down the Alt or Option key and choose to add a layer mask to this shirt layer. That's going to add a filled layer mask, a layer mask filled with black. I'm going to grab the brush tool. I'm going to set my foreground color to white by hitting the letter D, which resets your foreground and background color. And then you can hit the letter X, and that swaps foreground and background. And you can just make sure that white is your foreground color. And then paint with a simple medium-sized soft edge brush to bring back only the bits of this new shirt that we want, namely like the inside of the collar. Now, the color of the shirt is a little bit different than the color of our background image, so I'm going to add a selective color adjustment layer and just add a little bit of yellow here to the whites to match the color up a little bit better. And then I'm going to use the hotkey Command-Option-G or Control-Alt-G to clip this selective color adjustment layer to the new shirt layer below it. I can use the eyeball icon here to get a quick before and after. Now hold down the Alt or Option key and click the New Layer icon at the bottom of the Layers panel to create a new layer, but also pop open the New Layer dialog box as well. In this dialog box, choose to set the Layers Blend Mode to Soft Light, and then this option will appear. Just tick it on. It's the option that says fill the layer with a neutral 50% gray. This is going to be a good dodge and burn layer. So grab the burn tool and set the exposure of it to about 15%, and I'm going to paint in the lower area of the inside of the neck to darken that up. It's going to help add depth and sort of build out this illusion even more. Next, and this part of the tutorial is totally optional, you can head over to a site like brusheasy.com or really any Photoshop brush site and find some nice smoke brushes. Download them, save them somewhere on your computer. I'm going to use the eyedropper tool to sample the brightest highlights in the background, and I'm going to grab one of the smoke brushes and use the square bracket keys to reduce the size of the brush until I've got a poof of smoke that looks like it would, you know, about work. Now I'm going to paint using that very bright highlight color that we just sampled from a background a moment ago. Only one click, just one simple click with the brush will get the job done. And then I'll try setting this layer to something like the overlay blend mode. I'll create a new layer. Maybe I'll set this new layer to the overlay blend mode as well and use another smoke brush to create this nice poof of smoke around his head. And I can build this effect out as big or small as I want. Then I'm going to select any smoke layers that I have. I'm going to group them together by hitting Command or Control G. And I am going to add a blank layer mask to this group. And then I'm going to use the brush tool and, again, reset my brush to like just a very simple, soft edge, medium-sized brush. Set my foreground color to black. And I'll simply paint away bits of smoke that don't look like they belong. So we can get a quick before and after. Here it is with the head on. And here it is with the head off. Nice and easy. That's it for this one, folks. If you enjoyed this tutorial, if you thought it brought you any value, consider picking up a copy of my Photoshop course. A link will appear right up there. It's all about how to retouch images in Photoshop. I think you'll really like it, and it helps support this channel. So if you pick up a copy of the course, thank you so much. If not, we got plenty of free tutorials here on the channel. Make sure you subscribe and check them all out. If you do create this headless character effect, I would love to see it. Upload it to your Instagram if you have one. Tag me. My Instagram handle is @tutvid. Make sure you actually tag me in the photo and not just in the caption, because in the caption it shows up in my notifications and it's here today, it's gone tomorrow. Whereas the tagged images, I have a specific feed for that and I can get to it at any time, and I'll make sure that I see your image and show you a little bit of love, dap you up a little bit. So for creating this headless person effect here in the Photoshop, photo manipulation, whatever you want to call it. Guys, for this one, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.